Hi everyone, I'm Ax Sharma from Sonatype Security Research, and I'm sure by now you've all seen the Codecov supply chain attack that's been making headlines this week. Codecov supply chain attack is now being compared to SolarWinds supply chain attack. As you know, in case of SolarWinds, attackers had managed to push Trojanized updates to the users of Orion product, and that's how they managed to breach over 18,000 SolarWinds customers, including government agencies. Now, we still don't know the full impact of the Codecov breach, but essentially what happened here was Codecov was running a Docker image on their server, okay? And this Docker image, it had a flaw, likely a misconfiguration of some kind. And this misconfiguration is what let attackers get their hands on secrets stored inside that Docker image. And using these secrets, they modified a Bash Uploader script, which Codecov clients use. Codecov is a software testing company, you know, providing code coverage services and tools on GitHub that you can integrate with your product. And they have over 29,000 clients, including prominent names. So this kind of gives you an idea why would attackers target a developer tool like Codecov. So by obtaining the credentials to the Bash Uploader script from the Docker image, attackers replaced Codecov's IP address in the script with their own, and the unredacted IP address is published in Bleeping Computer's original report. And so essentially what happened is the client's data, such as their environment variables, it got uploaded to the attacker's IP address as opposed to Codecov systems. And this kept happening for roughly 2 months, up until April 1st, when a customer notified Codecov that, look, the SHA-SUM, the hash of your uploader script, does not match what you're saying is the right hash on GitHub. So investigation is still ongoing, and this attack is being compared to, you know, SolarWinds attack, which was linked to the Russian intelligence. As such, US government investigators have stepped in, and just now we are seeing, according to a new report from Reuters today, hundreds of client networks have been breached because of the credentials collected from Codecov. We still don't know the full impact of this breach, but it looks like this is not going away anytime soon. So just some takeaways here. One thing is container security has become indispensable. And you need to have some kind of automation in place that will deter, you know, detect and block suspicious activity as soon as it occurs. So for example, Nexus container, it has a layer 7 firewall. And as soon as, say, attackers would have managed to, you know, infiltrate your container, suspicious connections would have been flagged by Nexus container. And similarly, Nexus container can, you know, spot vulnerabilities in your container environments and also simple misconfigurations. So again, this is just a brief overview I wanted to give you to, you know, catch everyone up to speed. And FBI and DHS have declined to comment at this time, but it does seem like, based on these new details we're seeing, there's more to be learned from the story. Different teams at Sonatype are closely monitoring the Codecov supply chain attack. And should you have any questions or concerns, please get in touch with us. That's it for now, folks. Thank you.